Good morning, good afternoon, everyone. So I'm Frank Morales, Vice President at Orange Business Services for Connectivity Services and MEF Board Director. And I really do hope that you are all fine in this period. I'm delighted to open this MEF Infinite Edge series event. Even if, as probably all of you, I can't wait for being again in the same room somewhere at next MEF events in Q4 for having this kind of sharing in addition to social events. In the meantime, looking from my MEF board position, the tremendous and amazing work that you have been able to achieve over the period, I can tell you two things. First of all, it's a great thank you to all of you. The second point is, it is so important as the pace of the technology evolution and customer requirements have accelerated so strongly during and probably because of this period. Today's episode about cloud collaboration, delivering a unified customer's experience with what I'm about to share with you, is really spot on this fast pace and strong evolution. And all speakers of the day, including Sean Oak from Microsoft and Pascal Menezes, our MEF CTO, will probably not make me wrong on this assessment. So let me now start to share our views on this way of supporting customers' evolving challenges using a cloud-native approach. How we think that telco infrastructures could play an amazing role. How we need to reinforce tightly the relationship between network service providers, cloud network, and our security service providers and hyperscalers to deliver what our B2B customers are awaiting in their course of their digital transformation. But let's start with what our customers have been telling us over the past few months on this particular topic. First of all, they told us that their SD-WAN transformation was a key step for them to be able to cope with the crisis and the business evolution. They are not now in a position to continue and accelerate their transformation. I will not come back on SD-WAN and our flexible SD-WAN flagship offering, but this technology is really the foundation of their digital transformation. Secondly, CIO and CTOs told us that their positions, their roles, have changed within their companies. Only a few months ago, pre-pandemic, their role was somehow simply to run, quote-unquote, the IT or network business. Now they are expected to contribute to transforming the business, to make the business change and evolve thanks to the technology with very clear expectations in terms of accountability and return on investment. Finally, in such a context and facing such challenges, they expect us, all of us, to help them find the best balance between security, flexibility and performance while bringing to them the best of the technology. And more than ever, in this context of being cloud native, which is for them a big transformation. But let's make that more concrete with few customer demands we have formalized quoting our customers. As you can see on this slide, we can always theoretically elaborate scheme and way to go. But their requirements are quite concrete and really in the real digital transformation life that they are going through. Not going to all of them, but just highlighting few key points. Take this first one. We are moving to Amazon and Azure at the same time. How can I make my SD-WAN investment a cornerstone to the way to connect to via these hyperscalers? Highlighting that multi-cloud is as much foundation for digital transformation as SD-WAN is. The second one, I want to secure my cloud traffic by expanding my SD-WAN fabric to Azure from my data centers, usage of Azure Virtual One or other solution like Amazon Direct Access is a key demand. Third one, I want to keep a virtual private environment englobing my VPN network plus my virtual Amazon private resources. And on top, adding a strong security policy inside this virtual private environment, this one highlighting the importance of security policy while moving flows to and within the cloud, also in private environment with no more trust on the network. I will now go to the top left example, as I will deep dive on that one at the end of this keynote. So we can resume all this by speaking about a new paradigm where connectivity infrastructure complexity is moving from Earth to cloud. Connectivity infrastructure complexity is moving from Earth to cloud. Let me try to explain that by resuming this quite complex new slide. So far, and even if the connectivity to the cloud is now quite a standard topic, the main part of the complexity of the WAN was on Earth. To make sure that the routing, the security, the capacity management were fitting with the communications from sites to DC, a bit of site to cloud, but more importantly, from site to site. In this world, all network and security functions were located on Earth, as well as applications that users were connecting to. This has moved progressively to a configuration where the main part of the traffic is now from Earth to cloud. For applications, for unified communication usage with cloud-based solution, the site-to-site traffic has been transformed on a site-to-cloud traffic. As an example, during the pandemic, we have seen that quote-unquote cloudification of our customers' communications, collaboration, and customer relationship applications facilitated their ability to adapt their reactivity to maintain and develop the services intended for their customers. And in the meantime, with SD-WAN and cloud security solutions emerging strongly, a growing part of security and network functions are also cloud-based. Cloud meaning distributed outside of customer site. Could be within telco cloud infrastructure, but as well in hyperscaler infrastructure. Going ahead, flows are progressively moving upside down from site to cloud to site now, as there is now so much treatment, applications, communication in the cloud, with also the need for communication between cloud regions inside the hyperscaler infrastructure, such as Azure VNet, for example. Next step being the flow management between hyperscalers. So our customers are awaiting us to facilitate this one journey, moving the complexity from Earth to cloud. In order to make everyone comfortable, the complexity at site remains still a topic in parallel. With SD-LAN, with the Wi-Fi 6, with 5G, with IoT, with edge computing and other evolution to take care of. Don't be surprised of that. So, with such an evolution, what are the different ways to provide agility, security, and performance in a cloud-native world? Within Orange, we have launched a strong transformation to build a new generation international network, achieving our telco cloud infrastructure, transforming our global network towards a single, convergent, flexible, and cost-effective infrastructure. Leveraging this program, and thanks to our triple expertise as a network infrastructure operator, connectivity services integrator, and a cyber defense expert, we are able to bring more value for budget to our customers in three ways. Firstly, providing premium internet end-to-end as a combination of our internet backbone and our internet access management capabilities. Secondly, by developing a wide footprint platform from 40 at the end of 2021 to more than 100 next-gen hubs in 2024, which is a cornerstone of our telco cloud infrastructure. And thirdly, this platform also hosts VNFs to deliver our own services, but also welcome any vendors to make sure that we are providing best-of-breed services from selected technology partners at the right pace to our customers. The masterpiece of this program is the evolution of our NextGen Hubs, key pillar of our intelligent network platform. I would say it looks like a mech. I let you assess. Thanks to this infrastructure evolution, we guarantee to deliver the best performance, security, and flexibility without sacrificing one for another. And we have the ability within this platform to deliver on-demand network and security services to secure flows to and from end users wherever they are whatever network they are connecting to, and for whichever application they use. So how has this come about? NextGenHub is concretely a telco cloud infrastructure already in use today to host several VNF for our B2B customers, such as SD-WAN and SSL gateways, as well as for our wholesale needs, such as CDN. The specificity of this infrastructure is to be a unique crossing point to reach customer edge, Orange backbone, hyperscalers, and cloud-based security solution. Hence, this is the right place to provide our enterprise next-generation security, voice collaboration to our customers, and of course, SASE. The footprint extension driven by hyperscalers footprint from 40 POPs in 2021 to more than 100 POPs in 2024 is with the continued ambition to be at less than 10 milliseconds from our customers, with while we are already at less than 5 milliseconds of main cloud service providers. Finally, when it comes to the key topic of security, NextGenHub being the converging point for all the traffic is the perfect location to secure open customer policy, traffic from the branch to the cloud, ensuring traffic segmentation. Let's see now how NextGenHub is also serving our SASE evolution by welcoming technology partner services inside our intelligent network platform. These NextGenHub are open to our partners through APIs interconnection or using our hosting capabilities. This to ensure the challenge of fast release management to make sure that our customers are able to access to the latest feature for their preferred vendors in a secured and always available infrastructure. Let's take a concrete view on how we are onboarding partners in our NextGenHub in an API-based way, using this example based on our cooperation with one of our partners on their SASE product. In this example, we are exposing our API directly consumed by the partner's orchestrator for its SASE VNF deployment and lifecycle. The API we use are standard OpenStack API, providing an open solution with no vendor lock-in. In order to ensure an end-to-end service delivery, Orange Service Orchestrator pilots the partner orchestrator, allowing us to provide a unified customer journey, this is very important, and ensuring the attachment with other Orange services used by the customer, such as SD-WAN or IP/MPLS network. So we can see that this model requires a very tight relationship with cloud service security providers or network providers, as well as vendor partners. Let's move forward on being even more precise. This slide resumes with concrete use cases the transformation I have presented to manage and deliver flows to the cloud with the right level of security, performance, and agility. First of all, you can see this wide footprint of NextGenHub building a performant telco cloud infrastructure directly connected to our Tier 1 internet backbone and our MPLS network, already hosting lots of VNF, as for example SD-WAN gateways and advanced security features. Then, to make this very concrete, you can see these two use cases showing the importance of this infrastructure to provide the end-to-end solution fully secured, performant, and agile. First one being the site-to-cloud expansion of the SD-WAN fabrics thanks to SD-WAN gateway, then securing flows before connecting to the hyperscaler, Azure in that case, through private cloud connect, of course, express route for Azure. Second use case being SASE for remote workers with an SSL VNF hosted in our NextGenHub, adding SASE capabilities before connecting to hyperscalers thanks to an Internet Tier 1 backbone OTI. The white arrows are showing that all this could provide over-configuration in a very agile way as a telco cloud infrastructure is able to deliver. Services could not only coming from hosted solution, but as well from security and network solution cloud-based connected through APIs. Let's move now forward on addressing the needs of our customers into the cloud. The close relationship with hyperscaler comes with a really strong reality. Last year, we have announced our partnership with Microsoft Azure to continue to evolve above our own infrastructure by becoming a Microsoft Azure networking managed service provider. This to answer our customer requirements, we need to enrich our cloud network portfolio to manage connectivity from user to the application in a secure multi-cloud environment within Hyperscaler Fabric. To make that concrete, we have developed the following services, exactly mirroring the services we are used to provide from our own infrastructure on off. Consulting and design, security, inside Azure in that case, managed connectivity, visibility and performance. Becoming an Azure Network MSP enables us to develop managed services within the Azure network. This with the merge of our double expertise in connectivity and cloud, reinforcing our value proposition and acting as a full stack player, enabling us to address enterprise cloud networking needs and challenges across all areas of cloud and hybrid networking. I'm sure that Sean will elaborate more on this evolution and the necessity of tight relationship between service provider and hyperscaler from his Microsoft Azure position. But let's take a clear example. By using this real request of managing within Azure Fabric, the SAP flow management across several Azure regions using Azure Backbone in extension of our SD-WAN solution already deployed for this customer. As already mentioned, the SD-WAN transformation of this customer with our flexible SD-WAN solution was done. But then, how did we answer to this demand? We end up by managing this complexity, which is much more than to bring flows to the cloud, and in particular Azure in that case. For we are first of all managing the Azure Virtual One backbone usage, thanks to our move to become Azure Managed Network Service Provider, as already described, with full stack network and security design using Azure resources, including apps, express route, and firewall. But more than that, we are also managing the flows in the cloud Azure by combining our expertise on connectivity and cloud. This providing a full guarantee of high availability of ACP, thanks to the capability to replicate application across Azure region, to deploy accordingly also new application in Azure for this customer. As we are doing on Earth, we are also ensuring traffic control, proactive management by operational teams, ensuring as well a full continuity between our own infrastructure and the Azure Virtual One infrastructure. So at the end of the day, it is a perfect example of the new era where, due to cloud native evolution, we need for our customers to manage the one complexity moving from off to cloud. Thanks to this strong move, our customers can count on us to make sure that their cloud native first approach will be managed and that we will be able to smoothly transform and adapt their one to this cloud approach. So let's finish this keynote where I do hope I have been clear enough to demonstrate how we are moving to an ecosystem play with vendors and hyperscalers to manage the complexity of the one moving from Earth to cloud. Thanks for your attention. I hope you enjoy this Infinite Edge events